During my studies, I worked as a summer trainee at Elcogen OY. Elcogen OY is a leading company in solid oxide fuel cells and electrolyzer technology. I started working there as a summer trainee, and then I also did my master thesis with the company. And after my graduation, I continued as a permanent role as a R&D engineer at the same company.
I studied at Aalto University with the product development project minor, and then I was doing this knowledge intensive business here as well. The way I found actually the studies was true of the product development project course at the Aalto Design Factory, and that kind of led me to this path of design and development of new things and new products, new services. And at the moment I work as a service owner for a workwear service at the Lindstrom, which is something that I get to use a lot of the things that I've learned here.
Initially, when I joined Aalto, or when I applied to Aalto, it wasn't that clear to me which specialization in engineering I wanted to apply to, so I ended up choosing mechanical engineering rather arbitrarily. It seemed like a general all-purpose engineering field, and I was not really wrong about that. I think it was a very good choice. So after the bachelor's phase at Aalto, I chose mechatronics as my major for the master's. And this was really because I really enjoyed programming, control theory, among the mechanical aspects of mechanical engineering. And what I wanted to do was these more hands-on projects along my studies. And it ended up being the perfect choice. Mechatronics was exactly that.
In my studies, I have focused on production engineering and product development. I'm working with VR Fleetcare, which is a Finnish company that specializes in modernization and maintenance of rolling stock. So I started working at VR Fleetcare after my third year, when I had completed my bachelor's thesis. I was basically a summer trainee specializing in safety. And after that, I got a new position in the technical design team, and now I'm responsible for the acceptance process for specialty tools we use in maintenance.
During my initial months in Finland, I had a course at Aalto University called Finland Works. In that course, we learned about how to enter the job market, and that the first job in Finland is really difficult to find because you don't have any experience here, you don't know the language, and you don't have any networks. For me, it was a similar case, but I was fortunate in one sense that I had some networks with my professors. And regarding the Finnish work culture, I can name at least three things which have surprised me quite well. First thing is the Finnish work culture, which is stress-free and easy for me, at least. Yes, you have challenges and problems at work, but you also have a good support system of good colleagues who can help you tackle those challenges. Second thing is the work balance here, which is just amazing. You have really quite a lot of flexibility here to adjust your work hours and according to your personal life, and this is just really different for me here. And finally, one of the most important things for me here was that everyone is heard and valued.
So after my master's studies, there was a really interesting opportunity for me because of my master's thesis. I ended up coming to doctoral studies at Aalto, which turned up to be a really good choice for me. The PhD subject was about ship energy systems and how to control them, especially in the future, which also ended up offering a really nice job opportunity at the end of it, which was to Napa Oy, where I ended up going and working nowadays still. It has been a really interesting opportunity to work at Napa right now because the maritime sector is in such a tremendous inflection point due to the energy transition. The ship designs are changing, the way ships are operated is changing, and being at a company that is right in the middle of that change is really wonderful.
So my tip for students who are looking into moving into work life would be to keep an open mind when applying for jobs. For me, a supposed safety trainee position led to a position that was better suited for me.
One of the really coolest things about product development for me was that I got this process and the models and the methods that you can use in any of the industries. And this is something that I've been able to take then to Wärtsilä and Lindstrom. So when I graduated from here, I didn't know what I'm going to do. Kind of like the moment when I was graduating, I was thinking in my head that I'd really like to do like something cool with other people, like work with the cool people, do cool projects and make something for others. And then I started my career, and in the beginning it wasn't like that. And then I was at Wärtsilä and working as a service designer at that time, and there is this moment, I'm coming to Ha Long Bay in Vietnam, and I'm on the cruise vessel bridge doing my work, so observing the crew and the captains kind of working together and getting the vessel to the harbor safely. And my team was there, so I was there together with others, and I realized that, wow, now I'm there. Like, I'm here to see how these people work in order to be able to develop our bridge solution to be something that they can use in the future better. And that was the moment I realized that all the things that I had done in the past, during the university, during the years of my career, that it had led me to the moment that I was dreaming on during the graduation. So making these cool things with cool people and enjoying the ride at the same time.